Okay, coming to you, Larry, in 5, 4, 3, 2.
And welcome back to the public report. Our next guest is also from Niagara County. We have in our studios Roxanne Aubon Buckner. She's here from an awesome organization called Opportunities Unlimited of Niagara. Roxanne, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much, Larry. It's a pleasure.
Well, tell us a little bit about the organization, the history. What is this Opportunities Unlimited about?
We serve individuals with intellectual and other developmental disabilities who live in Niagara County or the surrounding communities. We have services from newborn all the way through senior and their families.
Wow. And what kind of services do you supply?
We have Medicaid service coordination, which is really your one-stop resource, and they help you to not only get services with our organization, but really put that jigsaw puzzle together of all the different services that you might be eligible for throughout the area, and help to get all of the services that both the individual with developmental disability needs and to support their families.
Now, is there a charge for this service?
It is primarily Medicaid funded. So when you're hearing the New York State budget, we are actually the other side of Medicaid. We're the taxpayer dollars that help people to, with dignity, learn skills that they need to become more independent and successful in the community, in their families, and in life.
And what kind of disabilities do you serve?
It's an intellectual or other developmental disability. Might be autism, cerebral palsy, Down syndrome, a neurological disorder that occurs before age 22.
How important is it for someone to access your service at an early age?
Very important, because we can help them with early intervention service coordination, which really is getting that person with the knowledge to help you fill out all the government paperwork for eligibility, help you with the doctors and the schools, but we can also help you with your landlord and really make sure that whether it's speech, the occupational therapy, the right schooling, assistance within schools, and then to transition into adult life. We are there to help you every step of the way. And that's really important. We also have group homes, we have day programs, we have supported employment where and vocational programs where people are actually earning a paycheck.
Wow, great. How many people do you actually help yearly?
We interact with nearly 700 individuals and their families on an annual basis, some for one program, some for multiple programs.
Okay. Now, since you mentioned the families, what do you do to help the families themselves?
Really, it's knowing that they have that professional, dedicated individual with many years of knowledge to help them through all, again, the paperwork, the transitions and the milestones through their child's life. We also have some support groups and information like that that's available to really help the families. We have respite through our recreation program so that your family member can go out with trained professionals, and now mom and dad have some time to either spend together or maybe spend it with the other siblings that are at home. And it's just that little bit of break, but your family member is going out with other individuals, making friends and recreating, learning.
Okay, let's go back a little bit, because you guys do so much, and I want to make sure we hit a little everything so people could understand for all that you do as far as respite and how important that is, because it does give the parents a break. Talk to us about maybe some of the misconceptions someone may have concerning someone with a disability.
I think the misconception is that our individuals are not capable of learning, of forming friendships, of really being a full part of society. Our individuals vote. They might live in a group home, they might live at home with mom and dad, they might live in a supported apartment. They just need a little bit of extra assistance. And who doesn't at some point in their life, right? And so our people need a little bit of extra assistance, maybe some therapies, art therapy, horticulture therapy, the nursing, but they just need a little bit of assistance. And that's really the misconception, is that our people can't. For us, it's our people can, and how do we give them an environment where they can learn, where they can work, and really achieve their dreams and goals for themselves.
Now, you mentioned the horticulture therapy. What is that?
excuse me. That actually is a unique program to mm-hmm. Western New York. We have a greenhouse and we have a certified horticulture therapist who really works with the senses. It's about smell, touch, activity. Mm-hmm. And our individuals grow everything from scratch that we sell. So this green plant here is actually grown from seed by our individuals in our greenhouse in Wheatfield. 150 individuals go through that greenhouse every week. They plant everything. They work with the soil. They make the bows. They pick out the silk flowers that will adorn the arrangements. And then they go out into the community and they either deliver them if it's a pre-sale mm-hmm. or they go out into a business where it's a cart sale and they actually are having the social interaction, the money learning skills, and really it's the joy of seeing someone buy something that they have helped produce.
So is this one of your fundraisers? So on this floral arrangement, who actually did that?
Our individuals.
Okay, great.
Grew everything. All the greens that you see are grown year-round mm-hmm. in our greenhouse. Our poinsettias and violets and things like that will come from a wholesaler because those are licensed goods. But our individuals put these together all year long. It is a fundraiser. We sell both plants for all holidays. You can also call us for a special occasion. We've done some centerpieces for major things at the Buffalo Convention Center. Hmm. And we've done some weddings. But really, it's that and the gardening classes, the greenhouse classes that mm-hmm. we have, and all of that's on our website. But the funds from that go right back into the greenhouse program to buy more supplies and to give the guys more opportunities. We're hoping to take advantage of going out to the botanical gardens and some other places this summer. But again, that's all either grants or individual donations that have helped in the purchase.
Mm-hmm. And that was going to be one of my questions, is how are you funded?
Besides the Medicaid dollars, it is people attending our special events like our golf raffle and our golf auction. We have an event. We have multiple events that our foundation runs mm-hmm. all year long. And it's really those grants that we get from regional and local organizations, corporate support, and individual donations really make that difference because that's over and above. Medicaid funding only goes so far. Mm-hmm. And to deliver the quality programming that we have a reputation of, that it's the individual donations that are really helping to make that difference.
Okay. Now we're coming up on one of the biggest floral arrangement holidays in the world. It's called Mother's Day. Without a shadow of a doubt. Why? And so is this for a fundraiser for Mother's Day?
It is. That's about a $25 arrangement.
Okay.
And you can either call us and get a brochure or you can go directly to our website and order online. And you can tell us whether you want to pick it up in Wheatfield or Lockport. But if it's a large group, a church or someone like that, all they do is call and talk to Bob Rakakowski and see mm-hmm. if he can arrange delivery.
And that was going to be one of my questions, do you deliver? All right.
For and, large group orders,
okay,
we do.
Okay. And so now you said they have to come to where? Lockport or where else?
Lockport or Wheatfield.
Or Wheatfield.
Our locations
okay.
are our main pickup areas.
Okay.
But if it's a pre-sale or a cart sale, all they need to do is talk to Bob and see if he can put it in the schedule because our individuals who participate in the greenhouse program love to go out in the community and make the deliveries.
Okay. And what is a cart sale?
A cart sale would be Ingram Micro has been very philanthropic to us where we go in and they announce us that we're coming in on a special day and we take items and usually we'll make items, the guys will make some items that are good for a desk type mm-hmm. of thing and then other items for you to take home.
Mm.
And live and artificial arrangements. And then our individuals are there throughout the day selling the goods. And then they come back home. So we're always open. AAA has also been a fantastic supporter. We actually have a cart sale going on there for Mother's Day.
Okay.
And so that's all. Any business or organization calls. The only thing we don't do is we don't take poinsettias into Erie County mm-hmm. because our sister agency, Heritage Centers, sells the poinsettias. But we will sell wreaths, Thanksgiving arrangements, all other holidays, absolutely. Anywhere in Western New York we can go.
Okay, great. If someone was in need of your service, what do they need to do?
They need to call our central intake phone number, which is 504-2617. And you speak to our admissions office and tell them about your situation, where you are. Do you already have eligibility from the state? Do you need to apply for eligibility? You're not sure. You need medical testing. Our people who are in our central intake office have more than 20 years experience, and so they really know how to help you through everything. If we can't help you, they know who to refer you out mm-hmm. to. We never just say, sorry, we can't help you. There's always that cross-reference. But really, that's the main way to get into any of of our programs, and then we suggest that the families take a tour, whether it's with their school group or with the family, mm-hmm. and tour our sites, see if we're the right fit for your family member, and then decide what program is really best. Mm-hmm.
Now, if there was a person in high school with disabilities, can you help that person, and what are some of the challenges that they face?
Absolutely. Some of the challenges they face is really with New York State determining their eligibility to go into the adult services. Mm-hmm. We do have a transition program for students who are currently in high school in Niagara County and the surrounding areas. They can actually come with their high school to shadow in our pre-voc and in our DAHAB programs, because in our pre-voc program we do assembly work, learn job readiness skills. In our DAHABs, they go out and volunteer in the community. They do Meals on Wheels, they help in area nursing homes, and they also recreate. We have programs for both the pre-voc and the DAHAB to go to Niagara University, where they're actually mm-hmm. learning on campus and experiencing college life. Okay. So for the high school, it's that, but it's also touring, seeing where they want to go for adult services, and then we help them with all the eligibility, because just because you had services in high school mm-hmm. doesn't mean in New York State now that you're going to be eligible for those services as an adult. And so it's critical while they're still in high school that their family members or their Medicaid service coordinator call our agency and start that paperwork going.
Mm-hmm. Now, what do you look for in a person that wanted employment or volunteer?
For employment, you must have a GED or high school diploma. There are some of our positions where more experience is required, but all of our job positions are on our website. Really, mm-hmm. what we look for is someone who's there for the mission. Mm-hmm. We are a nonprofit. The salaries are not the highest mm-hmm. in Western mm-hmm. New York to provide these kind of critical services to people with developmental disabilities. So we're really looking for someone with the heart and soul to want to help individuals secure greater independence. And that's really, we train you. Mm. Unless it's one of the jobs where experience is required, we train you with everything that you need to know to succeed. 14% of our 500 employees have been there for 20 or more years.
Mm, great.
And we do promote from within.
Mm-hmm. Now, what about recreation for someone with disabilities that's living at home?
If they're living at home, they can call our central intake and actually apply to go into our recreation program, and they mm-hmm. go out and they do dances, but then they also go out and you self-select on a two-month calendar which activities you could take. 30 activities, you could do one activity and decide what you want to do to go out with the recreation group. And we have both a teenage group and an adult group.
Okay, and so what do you have, transportation that will come and pick them up?
We do. We pick up and deliver door to door.
Okay, and now you said dancing. What other kind of recreation would they look forward to?
Everything that you and I go out. They have a bowling league. They hook up with different organizations. Really, it's everything from baseball games mm-hmm. to movies, theater, Darien Lake concerts.
And is that also free of charge, or would it all depend?
No, what happens is the family mm-hmm. self-selects on the calendar what they're willing to pay for, mm-hmm. and then they go out. I would love to say that we had enough grants to, right? to cover that. Maybe a donor will step forward mm-hmm. and want to help our families to be able to do that. But they self-select based on their own interests and their own ability mm-hmm. to afford the program.
Believe it or not, Roxanne, we're coming down to the last minute of the half of this show, and I want to make sure you leave with our audience what you want them to know.
I would just say, if you have a family member at home, no matter what age they are, to please call our central intake department. We were founded by parents. We are governed. One-third of our agency board of directors must include individuals, family members of individuals that we are currently serving. And that really does govern the philosophy of what we do. If you are a community member out there, purchase our plants, come to our greenhouse classes, and come to our events. We have fantastic events. Some are very unique to Western New York, and I encourage you to go to our website and help us any way that you can. We greatly appreciate it.
Okay, and they can always donate too.
They can always donate. It does. Every penny makes a huge difference. There's no such thing as a donation that's too small. It all goes to our fine arts program, our horticulture program, and our other programs.
Okay. Roxanne, thank you so very much for joining
us
today.
Thank you. This has been a pleasure.
All right, and please keep doing what you're doing, because you're helping a lot of people. And we encourage you to support Niagara Falls and that area, because we had them in the house today, without a doubt. But we also thank you all for joining us for another segment of The Public Report. Until next time, you and your family have a wonderful, wonderful day.
This has been Public Report. Public Report discusses the issues of interest and importance to our viewing area. Please remember that the views expressed by our guests are their own and do not necessarily represent the views of TCT or the station.